Hello! Alright, today I'm going to talk about the time that I dislocated my shoulder, my knee, and sprained my hand, and then spent nearly all night at the hospital. ER to be exact. Okay, so some backstory. My knee's dislocated, and I have to put them back in. It's a thing. So, I could go in depth about that later, you know, at a different point in time, but that's just something that happens. Alright, so this took place about a year ago. I think it was April. But anyways, our school had this thing. I'm not going to say the name of it because I'd give away the school, but our school has this production we do. A lot of Christian colleges have musicals that they put on, and my school's one of them, so we did that. And in some sororities, we have social clubs. And all this matters, so I'll get into that, but my particular club is the most competitive. You know, we win a lot. We won the year before, and that's like all we care about is winning. So I guess, you know, we're ready to win. And so we, you know, we're preparing. I didn't know if I was going to do it or not because of my knees, but I decided why not, and with the support of my boyfriend, who's awesome, you know, with his blessing, and not that I needed his blessing or anything, but with that, I was ready to go. I decided to do it, and so I worked out a lot to prepare for it. You know, I worked out, I had taken weight training previously. I'm in college, by the way, so that's where all this is taking place. I'd done weight training specifically for this, and it came the time, and I was ready. We went through all of our vocal rehearsals, and we went through practice. So I think we had done one or two. So this might have been our third practice, and we were going through. You know, I was dancing. We had a lot of things I normally wouldn't be comfortable doing, like squatting and jumping and running, especially running. Oh goodness, but it was towards the very end of the performance of the practice, and we literally had like 5 minutes until we had to leave the building because it's timed. Like our school takes this very, very, very seriously. And I think I was like turning, and as this was happening, sorry, I checked my phone. As I turned, there's if any of you has this condition also, where I guess everyone can relate to this, you can tell when you're about to get hurt, when you're about to fall, like a millisecond before it happens. Like, you know it's happening, and you have a moment to catch yourself. And I'm 5'10", so I have a little bit more time than most people, but I knew as I was falling, I'm like, you know, my knees already out, so I need to find a way to land so I don't fall on top of my dislocated knee. And it was this one. So when my knee dislocates, it comes out this way. So it kind of, you know, to be totally graphic, it went like hanging out here. So I felt that, and so I went to catch myself. I believe this is hand. I went to catch myself with this hand and land it in such a way, you know, to catch myself that I believe I karate chopped the ground right here. Oh my gosh, my hand hurts so bad. Sorry if my lipstick looks bad, by the way. I don't really like it. But anyways, like that. And of course I knew my knee was out, so I kind of was like yelling a little, like, ah! And they wanted to continue dancing. They didn't even realize I was hurt. They're like, oh, move out of the way. like my knee just came out. And so everyone was freaking out when they saw. And I, at this point, I was crying. And they'd gotten off stage. And I put it in as quick as possible. With the hand, I had just sprained, mind you. I put it in because my knee was the least of my concerns. But as this was happening, I kind of felt my shoulder hurt a little bit. But this was like a forethought. I'm like, my shoulder hurts. I might have dislocated that too, because I had done that before, but it was back in, you know, it had just rolled in, I guess, it just shifted out and came back in. I mean, things dislocate easily for me, that's no big deal. It's only an issue, like, 1 out of 5 times when something dislocates, and it's always my knee. My hips even tried to dislocate, but anyways, I mean, the shoulder was no big deal. That was the last thing I was thinking about. My knee was the second to last. My hand hurt so bad, and I'm crying. And they're like, we need to do our club cheer. You know, we gotta go out. And I'm just like, okay. So I'm crying my eyes out. You know, people are trying to help, but they're also trying to rush me. They're like, we gotta get out. We gotta get out. Like, no one is really taking it seriously. It really hurt my feelings, actually. It's like, this wasn't the first time I dislocated my knee for that club, but we went out front, did our cheer. I'm crying, you know, I'm not hopping or anything. I'm just standing there crying. And then I texted my boyfriend, and I said, you need to pick me up. I think I just broke my hand. So he comes, and I, at this point, I'm bawling my eyes out, and these girls stuck behind to see if I was okay. I don't even know their names, honestly. And so we got in the car, and my boyfriend, he was like, you know, are you okay? And I'm like blubbering, trying to explain to him, and like, I need to let my parents know. I think I called my dad first. By the way, this is at, like, 9 at night, 9, 10, like, it was kind of late, and we had gone to the emergency room. No, this was our first time going to the emergency room together. This was gonna be my first taste of an all-nighter. But anyways, yeah, so, called my parents, crying, told them happened, and you know, they were upset. I let my dorm mom, you know, we have dorm parents and we have curfew. I let them know, I'm going to the hospital, there's a chance I won't make curfew, because yeah, so I had to let them know. I let my roommate know. But I let my dorm mom know first, and I called her and, you know, kept her posted. And this dorm mom actually, like, cares about you. So she let other people at the school know, like, hey, Amanda got hurt, make sure you check on her, blah, blah, blah. But anyways, we went to the hospital. I was in so much pain. I kind of hobbled in my room real quick before we left to make sure I had my, some sort of identification so that they could bring up my health insurance and get everything taken care of and squared away. But I'm trying to be quick. This is probably gonna be a long story, I guess. But anyways, got there, I let everyone know. My boyfriend's so awesome, but I didn't grab any medicine because I was under the impression that if they saw someone screaming and crying, that they would at least offer Tylenol. But at this particular night, there was a lot going on at the hospital. So little did I know, I'd be there for a very long time. No, it was like 9:40 when we got there. So I guess practice was 8-ish. So I remember specifically checking the time when we sat down. And my phone was kind of dying, so I made sure that they had my boyfriend's number. I'm trying not to say his name, I might have already said it, but so that, you know, I could get in contact with everyone. And my shoulder, I didn't care about my shoulder. My knee hurt a little, but my hand, oh my gosh, it hurt so bad. We got there, they triaged me, I sat down. And then I begged for medicine. I'm like, we can't do anything. We have a lot of people tonight. And I got to the point where they had to triage me again because I was in so much pain I thought I was going to pass out. No such luck. But, you know, because I had ligaments dislocate, and that hurts with a sprained hand, and your hands are very sensitive, and there's a lot of tendons and nerves here. But anyway, so, yeah, we were there for a bit, and then, we met a few interesting people coming in. And the next thing you know, it was storming. There's a very big storm. Tennessee will randomly have them. And a lot was going on. As far as I'm aware, that night at least 2 people died. And there's another person I suspected that might have died. But I wasn't facing it. But my boyfriend actually saw a lady rush in and get the news that her husband had passed away. So, I mean, this is kind of a traumatic night for everyone involved. there's a lady whose nephew had passed away, and they've been waiting for hours to see the body to identify. So, you know, that was going on. And that same lady, this is kind of a funny story. She had gotten up and left behind a little present. Apparently her bra wasn't comfortable, so she ripped the underwire out of it, and it was like that big of a, it was a huge wire. But anyways, so, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, it was like, they did my x-rays really quick. I told them not to worry about my shoulder. They just did my knee and my hand because I was worried about how much it cost. And so we were waiting forever, though, after the x-rays. And then it was like 4 something by the time they were like, that it's just a sprain, your knee's fine. And they gave me like 5 Norcos. That's it. And they sent me on my way. And they only gave me enough to last like 3 days for pain. So we stayed there all night long. All night long. Just for that. And so we were going to fill my prescription. We tried Rite Aid and we tried CVS. And both of them denied my healthcare, and then I got to the point where I was like, how much is it? And they said it was just $12, so that was annoying. And then we, the dorms open back up at 5, because they close at 12:30, like, at the time, they automatically would lock, and so it was unlocked at the time. I let my dorm mom know. I'm like, I texted her, I'm like, we're back, you know, and we were texting family and other staff members of the church, because I have a very strict college, and they check on you, making sure you're telling the truth, especially if you're with a member of the opposite sex. But my boyfriend deserves a trophy for that, staying with me all night. And he gained a lot of respect with my family because of how he handled that. He gained a whole bunch of respect. He's a very good guy. I don't know what I'd do without him, but the club was pestering me. They're like, are you still going to do this? At first, I was apprehensive, but I missed 1 or 2 practices, and I got back in there, and we won. Yay. And at the time, this was towards the end of the semester, the spring semester. Side note, we had a clean sweep where we had to scrub our dorm rooms clean, and my roommate didn't want to help that much. She wanted to do her own thing, so I was on my hands and knees scrubbing with a sprained wrist, and I've never cleaned a sink so well in my life. That thing sparkled, but our room looked good. we won the musical thing. My boyfriend's awesome. And I guess I thought that'd make for a good story. My first story time. So, let me know if you like it. I took off my glasses so I can't see how bad the lipstick looks. Without glasses, it's blurry, so it looks good. But, anyways, let me know how you liked this, and I'll talk at you later. Bye.